died in the soft green English countryside, a place called Kensal Green. The people of the village tried to speculate on what he'd done and where he might have been. The children of the village had made fun. They laughed at him no matter where he went. His eyes a stare, a shock of hair, his body bent, his skin all gnarled and rent. John McDowell Stewart, rider in the Mirage. John McDowell Stewart, with his tiny entourage, on his pretty grey mare Polly, in the burn and sand and sun, intrepid man. Number one,
number one.
Five times McDowell Stewart tried, but at every turn he was defied by salt and sandy piles. His faithful Kickwick by his side, it seemed like an eternal ride, 10,000 weary miles. The steel-shod desert drove him back, he floundered to and fro and Polly reeled. But off again and then again, determined still, he vowed he'd never yield. John McDowell Stewart, rider in the Mirage. John McDowell Stewart, with his tiny entourage, on his pretty grey mare Polly, in the burn and sand and sun, intrepid man. Number one,
number one.
Kiteage tribesmen drove him back, bewildered nomads in attack, red desert men of old. But back he came to try again, through the lancewood scrub and the open plain, the Scot was truly bold. His body racked with fever, he fought with death, postponed it for a day, till finally they battled through, McDowell Stewart and gallant crew and Polly all the way. John McDowell Stewart, rider in the Mirage. John McDowell Stewart, with his tiny entourage, on his pretty grey mare Polly, in the burn and sand and sun, intrepid man.